Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Valencia in Spain. Thank you very much to a fantastic band down on the grid, cheering us up for what's going to be our finals afternoon here at the Lucas Guerra circuit for the 2017 Winter Cup title from four categories. Of course, we've got the Minimax, we've got the Juniors, we've got the Seniors and the DD2s later on this afternoon. But what a way to kick us off, and they will be with us hopefully throughout the afternoon here to make sure all the carts get onto the grid nice and safely. So we're very shortly to get underway with the Minimax final here at the Lucas Guerra circuit. Before we get underway, let's hand down to Jenny Wade on the grid, who is with our pole man at the minute. Let's go down to Jenny with Ollie Pilker.
So, Ollie, all set for the final? Yes?
Yes.
You had some good racing today and yesterday. Pole position, winning all your races, fantastic.
Yes, fantastic.
Okay, we're going to let you go. Get ready. Good luck. Also to all the other drivers. Who else can we catch? Over here. Jezik. Okay, Jezik, now it's been tough racing, hasn't it? Little grid, but close racing.
Yeah, I will try to go because we have some problems with the straight, but I will try to go.
I'm sure you will. And what about your teammate over there on pole position?
Oh, he's so faster than me because he has he hasn't got problem with the straight, so he has easier to drive.
Yes, and I think he's got a little bit of trouble because both of you are going to chase him, aren't they?
Yeah.
Okay, who else can we speak to? Ah, Giraffe, hiding down here, our pole position man from Friday. Little bit of a tough race weekend, huh?
Yeah, because it has been raining. I'm not good in the rain, but now it's dry, so I think I can win it.
I don't think there's very much rain in Dubai, is there?
Not really. It barely rains.
Well, you never know what's going to happen here in front of you, and I think we're lucky it's not going to rain.
Yeah, I'm really happy that it's not raining.
Okay, we're going to let you go. Good luck. Enjoy the race. And everyone else is ready to go. We enjoyed the music. Keep watching us also if you're out there in the paddock or at home on Telemundi. Leave it up to you, Matt. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Jenny. So Jenny Wade down on the grid speaking to some of our drivers from the Minimax class, which very shortly will be heading off on their first of two formation laps here at the Lucas Guerra circuit. Lots to look forward to this afternoon. As Jenny said, if you're watching on telemundi.com, thank you very much for joining us once again. We've got a very exhilarating afternoon in prospect with four finals coming your way, three grand final tickets up for grabs, and of course the crown of the 2017 Winter Cup to look forward to as well. So do not move a muscle, stay right where you are, either here at the track or watching at home, because we've got some great excitement to come here on what now is a drying track, because overnight from last night into this morning we have had some wet weather, but for now it is starting to dry up, and we have had a little bit of a dry line appearing through the latter pre-finals, and during the lunch break a few drivers were out there testing the track, and I had a little bit of a walk as well, and there is some dry lines about, but as soon as you skirt offline onto that wet stuff it could be quite treacherous. In the earlier pre-finals we had the Minimax and the juniors and pretty much the seniors all on wet tyres. For now though, I can see that the Minimax drivers have gone for slick tyres, so they're confident that it's going to dry out enough for them to use them to the best of their ability. So we'll see how that all features in the next, what's going to be 12 laps for the Minimax. They've increased their distance once more from the pre-final, so 12 laps of racing to look forward to, which gets underway in just 5 minutes time. Local time at 12:50 is when the Minimax kicks off. If you want to find your favourite race, or you just want to join us for the whole afternoon, then you're more than welcome, but the specific times for each final are as follows. The juniors get underway at 1:20, the senior final will be underway at 1:50 local time, and DD2 final will be at 2:20 this afternoon, so make sure you can join us for as many of those as possible. We'll have the podiums for you as well. Great atmosphere with the podiums, all the drivers gathered together. That will take place at 3:30, around about 3:30, so make sure you stay with us on telemundi.com for all the podium action. And don't forget, a busy season ahead, because the first round of the Rotax Max Euro Challenge kicks off at the Genk circuit in Belgium on the 29th of March to the 2nd of April. And just to make you aware, if you're a driver, the entrants open tomorrow, so if you want to get your entry in, tomorrow is the date when it all opens, so make sure you flood the RGMMC team with all your entries for the first round in just around about 6 weeks time. So then, all the drivers near enough now into the carts. Just got Gianni Andrazani, who's waiting to jump in, but he's just been doing a few laps around the kart just to keep himself warm and keep that adrenaline pumped up as well for when the race gets underway. In terms of the grid for you then, we'll take you through that in just a few minutes time, but we've got some very young stars making their name heard here this weekend, as we saw on the grid. Jenny speaking with Daraf Kendi, the 11-year-old from Senegal and the UAE. He's been a winner of the Dubai Oplate and also the winner of the Al Fazan as well. He, in his spare time, likes to do a bit of football and would one day like to be a Formula One driver as well. One of his favourite circuits being that of the Dubai Autodrome. So good luck to Daraf Kendi. The 11-year-old, been racing now for 3 years. He had his troubles yesterday in the heats. He had a great qualifying on Friday, but it's kind of not come to the foray just yet. But the final could turn around in his favour. Teammate to Oli Pilka, that of Jerzy Spinkiewicz, the 12-year-old who's been racing now for 3 years, sits on row number two. The Polish racer, who is vice champion of the Polish Championship in 2016 and also finished fifth in the Euro final last year as well. A man who'd like to be like Sebastian Vettel in the near future. And again, for Jerzy Spinkiewicz, in his spare time, he likes to do a little bit of diving as well. And one day he'd like to win the ticket for the grand final, which everyone wants to do. That's a big end of year climax, a great event. The grand final tickets up for grabs here this weekend. The man you can see on your picture, left of the screen, on pole position, kart 413, is Oli Pilka, our pole man. He's had 3 wins yesterday. He had 1 win this morning. He has been a dominant force within the Minimax opening winter event this year. The 11-year-old, who's been racing now for 6 years, races with Unique Racing, comes from Poland. Again, he is a three-time Polish champion and was also P2 on the CEE scene a few years ago as well. He'd love to win the world champion, one of his favourite circuits being that of the Adria Raceway in Italy. Also in this field, great pre-final for Balázs Valente, who starts second on the grid. He's definitely shown his form today. Let's see if he can carry that through into this final. A man who comes from Budapest in Hungary, the 10-year-old, now been racing for 6 years, so started very young in the karting scene. He's also been a CEE fourth in the Hungarian Championships. Nobby Michaelis is one of his idols that he looks up to in terms of racing. Victor Abarzanek as well out there on the grid, the 11-year-old who's been racing just for 1 year, so a very new name to the karting scene as well. Victor Abarzanek will start on the second row of the grid. The man you, or the youngster you just saw there, waving his arms just to try and stretch himself as best as possible. He'd like to be like Robert Kubica, the man who made his name in Formula One and more recently has raced in the World Rally Championship as well. And the man towards the back, who had a great heat today but struggled this morning in pre-final, that was Gianni Andrazani. But now that the conditions are starting to dry, Gianni Andrazani could possibly be a man to look out for from the third row. The 10-year-old has been racing now for 4 years. He is partner with RS Competition, comes from Germany, one of his favourite circuits being Wackersdorf in Germany. And in his spare time, he likes to play a bit of football, likes to play on the PC, and also likes to take part in as many games as possible. One of his sayings as well is, no risk, no fun. Couldn't agree more with that statement from Gianni Andrazani, who starts to the back of the grid. Not the most competitors for Minimax, but this is going to grow as the season goes on. A first stepping stone for this year to bring Minimax to the fore of Rotax Racing. And it's great to have all these youngsters on the grid, just under 12 years old, most of them. And they're looking forward to a great season ahead. As we said, as soon as the championship gets underway at the Genk Circuit in Belgium, we're looking to have many, many more competitors on the grid for that first round. So very much looking forward to the season kicking off. But before that, this small matter of crowning a Winter Cup champion. Who is it going to be? Time to place your money once again on one of these youngsters. The grid very shortly will set up off on their first formation lap. They'll get two formation laps and then we'll be set to go with 12 laps of action for the Minimaxes. Very shortly, you'll hear the carts fire into life and now head off around this Lucas Guerra circuit. You can see just slightly on the screens now that there is a drying line on the racing line, but as soon as you step off that, as I said, it's going to be very, very slippy indeed. But we have got a small glimpse of sunshine just poking through and the temperature's gradually rising as well. Currently 13 degrees here at the minute as the carts now fire up and head off onto that formation lap here at the Winter Cup final for Minimax. So then, grid away for this Minimax final, and the way it's going to line up is follows, like this. Ollie Pilker will start from pole position in kart 413. Alongside him is going to be Balazs Valente, who gave Ollie a great run for his money in the pre-final earlier this morning. Row 2, then headed by Victor Abarzanek with Jazik Spinkovic alongside, and then back on row 3 we'll have the likes of Daraf Kendi, who was quickest on Friday in qualifying, but has struggled across the rest of the weekend. Alongside him, watch out for the German Gianni Andrazani, who should be right to the front once the race gets underway. Six competitors ready to take part in this Minimax final as the carts work their way on this first formation lap. Lucas Guerra circuit comprises 13 turns. A couple of chicanes are chucked in for good measure. A nice few sweeping corners and some flat out parts of the circuit as well. A very long back straight where the competitors are now just working their way down, which goes on for quite a while, and it leads you into a very fast right-hander down at turn 12, where very rarely you get off the accelerator. You keep it flat out until you hit the final chicane. Thomas Leiner, I can see, just on top of the gantry, just telling the drivers to slow down because the grid is getting quite spread out here at the minute. And of course, for a start in the Rotax Championship, you have to keep yourself as closely bunched as possible. And that's exactly the same this weekend here with the Winter Cup. So they're all going to have to just slow it down gradually. Ollie Pilker, of course, will be used to this. He's been leading the field now for pretty much the whole weekend from this morning with the pre-final, and of course with the heats yesterday, he was towards the front anyway with Daraf Kendi around him. He was on the outside line for that occasion, but now Ollie Pilker has the privilege of being on the inside, just like he was this morning. So let's see how he copes with it this occasion, being hounded all the time there down in towards turn 9 on this warm-up lap by Balazs Valente. He'll want to get this race underway and try and carry that form he had this morning into this afternoon's final. We've got Gianni Andrazani. Everyone's a little bit out of position here for some reason. Not too sure what's going on. Balazs Valente needs to get back to the front. Gianni Andrazani needs to drop to the back, which he's now done. And there, coming through the field, is the second place man. So everyone now into position, right side of the track, which is good to see. And the six carts from this Minimax Rotax Winter Cup get themselves now into a great grid order. They'll come through the chicane. They'll go through their grid hatchings. As soon as the red lights go out, we are set for 12 laps of racing. The Minimax final and the Winter Cup champion is about to be crowned for this class as the lights go out. Away we go, down towards the first corner. A great start from our pole man, Ollie Pilker. A bit of bumping and barging there because that was Balazs Valente just being pushed wide there by 416, which was Victor Abarzanek trying to get his way through, which he's done. So Victor comes through up into second place as now Gianni Andrazani's made a great start comes alongside the cart there of Balazs Valent, but he can't quite get through. Giraffe Kendi's getting in the mix as well towards the back of the field. And just like that, Gianni Andrazani now dropped to the back after trying for a new move for third place. He's gone from third down to sixth position. So not the start he would have wanted, but a cracking start, as has come expected now from Ollie Pilker, who leads the field down towards turn number nine, already bridging a gap over 4-1-6, which is Victor Obozanek. Then they're in third place. You've got the recovering Balazs Valent after nearly being squeezed wide down towards the first corner, but he's managed to recover and stay where he is. Then behind that, you can see the likes of 4-1-2, which is Zeke Spinkovic. Great run in the pre-final, but now he's being passed by two people because Giraffe Kendi and Gianni Andrazani has now gone through into fourth and fifth. So the dry conditions may not suit him that well on this occasion, as the encouragement starts to come from the pit wall once more as the six carts head across the line now to start lap number two. Let's see what Balazs Valent can do to get back past Victor Obozanek as they turn their way on towards the second corner. Balazs is probably looking the more racier of the three out front at the minute, but Ollie Pilker will just have his chance now to cool those tyres down, keep himself in a good stride here, keep those tyres nice and clean, and then maybe towards the end start to use them to the best of his ability. But for now, he doesn't really have to try. He can keep himself out front, he can watch what goes on behind, and hope that Victor Obozanek keeps those at bay for the time being. Head down for the youngsters then as they work their way off the short straight, just try and get the best of the slipstreams and more of a toe from the cart in front. And man in third place there, Balazs Valent, not quite getting as close as he probably would have liked to Victor Obozanek as they turn their way on towards the back straight once more. Giraffe Kendi's done a fairly good sector one, quickest of anyone. Sector two has just been beaten though, because Victor Obozanek has gone quickest there. So let's see if he can record the quickest time in this race so far on their first flying lap as they come across the line once more. Still Ollie Pilker that leads. Victor Obozanek second, 7/10 of a second adrift then of the leader. But right with him at the minute is Balazs Valent, and getting ever closer at the minute is Giraffe Kendi, who is slowly but surely starting to reel the top three in here. So watch out for Giraffe Kendi there in fourth place, who has just gone through to do the quickest lap of anyone, 103.469. So a great lap there from Giraffe. Gianni Andrazani is still fifth, and Jazik Spinkovic is down there in sixth position. Trio then on their way down towards turn nine. Lap three has been started. Gap out front now reads at 1.1 seconds. So already on this lap, Ollie Pilker putting more and more gap between himself and the second place fight, which is now starting to become a fight, because Balazs Valent is not really dropping back from our second place man, Victor Obozanek. So let's see if he can get his way through on this next lap. Probably not close enough into the chicane, so he's just going to have to wait for a minute as they work their way through the right-left-right flick. If you can get a good run through that final chicane and a nice toe down towards the first corner, that is a potential passing opportunity. But again, don't think Balazs Valent is quite close enough for now as they turn their way through the first corner, which loops itself round. A great place to get the slingshot on towards turns two and three. Ollie Pilker there, as you can see now, has recorded the quickest time, 103.154. So he now has extended that gap to 1.1 seconds, as we saw just around about a lap ago on our timing screen there. It's now out to 1.3 already through sector one. So more and more time being put between himself and Victor Obozanek, who in turn is still being closed down here by Balazs Valent as they work their way off the straight in towards turn nine, slightly wide there. But of course, now the track continues to dry even further. Looking around the circuit, it seems that most of the track now is dry. It's only the start finish line where we've got two different lines of one wet, one dry. But the rest of the circuit, with the carts going round and running wide, it does mean that the dry line is getting wider and wider. So they'll be able to use that now to their ability and try and make a few more moves in different places once again. When it's drier, we seem to get better racing, which is good, as the leaders come through once more. Slightly wide there from Balazs Valent. He just caught the curb on the exit. And of course, the curbs, which don't rarely get used, will be still very slippery. So you don't want to put too many wheels over those curbs. It means Balazs Valent has lost time now because Giraffe Kendi has closed him down. So third and fourth is the next battle to watch out for. And the reason being for that is Giraffe Kendi's just gone and been the quickest man of anyone in this race, a 103.029. So Giraffe Kendi now looking to get himself on the podium after being quickest on Friday in qualifying, being nowhere in yesterday's heats, finally has come back to the front of the field now. So Giraffe Kendi has left his best moves until the end of the weekend, which is when it counts, of course, the most points on offer in terms of getting yourself to the top. And let's see now if Giraffe Kendi can find his way through. Around the right hand of they turn at turn 11, which again is a very sweeping corner. And a great run from Giraffe Kendi down the back straight to the inside line. And he gets himself up into third place. So he's gradually getting towards the front now. Giraffe Kendi doing a sterling job as he comes through. What can he now do about the man ahead, which is going to be Victor Bolsonek? As they cross the line, he is just over half a second adrift of that second place man. But he can see him in front of him. He can see that that gap is coming down. He's got the grip between his teeth now. Giraffe Kendi, can he get through as they work their way now on this, the sixth lap of the race? So not quite a half race distance, but we are getting there slowly but surely. Man out front, Ollie Pilcar, starting to put more and more time between himself and the second place man. 1.6 seconds, but with the speed that Giraffe Kendi is showing here, I wouldn't say that's comfortable at all at the minute for Ollie Pilcar, and it could yet be closed down between the top two as they work their way again down the short straight in towards turn number nine. Giraffe Kendi needs to think quick here. He needs to get past as soon as possible before the lead of the race starts to slip away from him. Let's see if he gets a good run through the right-hander at turn 11. This is where he seems to be really, really quick. He gets the grip. He's got the cart working really well, and he's closing down the gap again into turn number 12. So let's see if he can get ever closer into the water chicane, almost onto the bumper now of the second place man as they come through on towards the start-finish line. Look how close they are. Here comes Giraffe Kendi. He's got a great turn of speed through the final corner. Alongside he goes down towards turn one and through. Already has gone Giraffe Kendi, but now fighting back to the inside was Victor Bozanek. So no room left there for either of them, and Victor didn't want to give up that second place easy at all, did he? He wanted to make Giraffe Kendi work ever harder for it, so now he's got to try again as they work their way through the right-hander at turns four and five. Giraffe Kendi again, even with that move, has gone quicker than anyone. A 102.744, the first man in this race to grace the 102s, because everybody else is still down in the 103. So Giraffe Kendi really showing a good turn of speed here as he works his way through turn nine. No way there through on Victor Bozanek. But again, it's the end of the lap that Giraffe Kendi seems to work well. Let's see if he can get a good kind of toe through the corner. You've got to be very, very close there, but you can also make a mistake. He picks up an immense amount of speed down the straights here. Not too sure what they've done to the car, but it seems to be working for him. Late on the brakes, into the chicane, and he goes through. What a move there. He pushes out wide Victor Bozanek, and in the process, Giraffe Kendi has now gone through. So Giraffe up into second. We've got Balazs Valente up into third as well. And in that one foul swoop, Victor Bozanek has gone from second to fourth place. So it just shows how quickly your fortunes can change. But Giraffe Kendi now wants to end the weekend where he started it, pretty much on top of the pack. And he's not going to be too dishappy with this, is he? Because he's now only 2.6 seconds back from Ollie Pilcar. But in clear air, surely he's going to be a lot, lot quicker. Whether he was aided with the slipstream that he was given from Victor Bozanek, we'll have to wait and see. But let's see if he can work to his own devices and try and catch up with the man out front, Ollie Pilcar, who leads, as I said, by 2.6 seconds. There's a fight here for what's going to be third place now. Victor Bozanek is back through by the looks of it, yes, on the Balazs Valente cart. So they've switched positions. Gianni Androzani is now with them as well in fifth place, and Jazik Spinkovic is down in sixth position, quite a way back from the leaders at the minute. So he's got some work to do to catch up. Here comes Giraffe Kendi. First lap on his own, pretty much. What does he do? 102.744 as his quickest time. That lap was a 103.1 as down the inside tries to look there. Balazs Valente, they give themselves enough room. Victor Bozanek then runs wide. Gianni Androzani comes around the outside. Is that going to be the correct line for turn three? Yes, it is, because Gianni now goes through as well. And Victor Bozanek drops down to fifth place. If you thought this race couldn't get any worse, it pretty much just has for Victor. So he now sits down there in fifth position with Balazs Valente and Gianni Androzani now through. Let's see what they can do to catch up with Giraffe Kendi. Gianni's going to try for a move though off the back of the straight in towards turn nine. He goes through, runs wide, hands the plate straight back. That's kind of a common maneuver that happens down there. If you're too late on the brakes, you're just going to run out wide and give the place back to the person you're racing with. So that doesn't work for those two carts. But again, three as one for third place. And of course, this is all important to get the final step on the podium. Who is it going to be? It's going to be one of these as Victor Bozanek dives down once more the inside at the chicane to get a great move done there on the Gianni Androzani cart. So Gianni Androzani now down to fifth, the German. He's going to fight back once more though. The green and white car goes to the inside and he gets the place back away. Great racing from these youngsters. They may be young, but they're definitely showing some of the older guys how to race around this Valencia track. On towards the right hander they go once more. Here comes Victor for a dive down the inside at the sweeping right-hander at turn five. Gianni Andrazzani has to let him go on this occasion once more. So there's another swap of fourth and fifth places. And it's this time Viktor Obosnek that goes back in front on this, the 10th lap of the race. Gianni's going to fight back though again. He's going to outbreak himself shortly as he dives down the inside line. Yes, he does. Still contact though between the two. Very small amount of contact, but they managed to squeeze their way through without too much drama. Meantime, leader, there he goes, down the back straight on his own. Olli Pilka in towards the completion of another lap. He now leads Daraf Kendi by 3 seconds. I think he's going to extend this time through as well as Olli goes through a 102.7. Daraf Kendi does a 102.7 as well, slightly quicker, which now gives him the quickest lap of this race. So Daraf is not backing off. He may see Olli slipping away in the distance, but he's going to try as best he can right till the end of this race. Now as we start lap 11, there is confirmation of the quickest lap from Daraf Kendi. Been down the field, as we said, in the pre-finals. But as the finals come into appearance, he seems to be working very well. And of course, first time away from the UAE for Daraf. First time racing within the European Championship. So a new territory for him, but he seems to have got to grips with it towards the end of this weekend. Sun is starting to come out as well now for the first time today, so a little bit of sunshine just warms the temperature up and helps the track dry out that little bit quicker, which it almost has done now, as we said, just the start finish line that seems to be a little bit damp, and also there as well the back straight with a few damp patches on it. But that hasn't put off Olli Pilka, who is on his way now to start the last lap of this Minimax final. Through he goes, and he's just got one more chance to prove himself here. He doesn't really need to do it. He's got a nice gap of 3.1 seconds. He's retaliated with now the quickest lap of the race, a 102.688. And then Daraf Kendi has got no answer, unfortunately. He had the answer to everybody else, but unfortunately to Olli Pilka, he was just that too stronger opponent this weekend. And a great job Olli has done. Already looking to the future is this youngster, as he now works his way on through turn seven onto the short back straight, which is completely opposite the main back straight, near enough the same length, just slightly shorter. Down in towards turn nine, Olli goes in with this over 3 second lead. He's coming down on this lap as well, but Daraf Kendi cannot close down 2.9 seconds, I'm afraid, in just three corners. So it looks like Olli Pilka's got it set. He now just needs to pretty much cruise it to the line, and that should be job done, weekend done, with five race wins in the chance of five. He's taken them all. He's done a grand job, has Olli Pilka. The Minimax Winter Cup champion is going to be Olli Pilka, who works his way through the final corner to take the checker flag here in Valencia, Spain, for the Winter Cup title. He is going to be a delighted man when he stands on top of the podium later this afternoon. He's going to slow himself down. He'll get the applause of all the marshals around the track, all the team down when he reaches the pit lane once more. But Olli Pilka has done what he needed to do best this weekend, prove himself with the five wins, three heat wins yesterday, a pre-final win, and of course the most important win of the weekend, the final win which grants him the Winter Cup champion. Well done to Olli Pilka. He in the end wins by 2.8 seconds over Daraf Kendi. Daraf on that final lap though did do the quickest lap, a 102.500. So Daraf Kendi classified in second. Balazs Vallant then comes through third for Agaiti Racing. Fourth place for Viktor Obosnek for Unique Racing, the man, of course, who races with the same team out front. Gianni Andrazzani comes through in fifth for RS Competition. And sixth place for Jazik Spinkovic. Great pre-final, but he just dropped away towards the end there for Unique Racing. So well done to him. Well done to Olli Pilka. Unique Racing are the winners of our first final of the day here in Spain, and of course I'll take that accolade away.